My name is Bob Crow. I'm the chief of the Canton, New York Fire Department. We're a small department about a half hour from the Canada-New York border. We serve about 8,000 residents plus two four-year colleges in our town. When we're replacing our pumper, we're looking for a simpler workhorse pumper that would do the job without being overly difficult to operate. So we are looking for a smaller wheelbase pumper, short height. One of the problems that we've noticed is apparatus is getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And we wanted something a little smaller that was easier for the firefighters to work off of, an easier platform. So one of our primary goals was to lower the hose beds. And we're able to achieve that with this truck with a lower crosslays and a lower hose bed in the rear. Our previous truck required mounting the tailboard to access the hose. In our winter weather, that became perilous. So being able to do it from ground level was important for us in the design of the truck. So one of the benefits that we find with this truck is the command zone or CZ Connect that will monitor service intervals and any issues with the apparatus, and we'll display it on the screen there. It's much easier for us for maintenance purposes and diagnostics. When we're choosing our cab layout, we're looking for something that was simple, firefighter friendly, easy to clean, easy to maintain. So we also needed the space in the cab. So this cab design provides a roomy interior, so it's comfortable for our firefighters while we're responding to calls. It's much quieter than the apparatus we have now. You can actually carry on a conversation in the truck without having to shout from the front to the back. When we were looking at our pump panel, we wanted to make it easy for our operators to identify what gauge and valve and lever was what. We also wanted the low crosslays so that they could be accessed from the ground and not require stepping up on a running board, particularly in the wintertime when we're going to have ice and snow build up on the running board. We find that the layout that we came up with was pretty easy, and we actually picked it off another truck during our pre-con walk around to the plant, which we found to be extremely helpful in looking at options that we hadn't considered or didn't know were available. Our pump operator's compartment, one of the things we saw also on our walk around was this cabinet that will help us organize our fittings and other loose material that in our current apparatus are floating around in the pump operator's compartment. Because we've chosen to go back to what I call slam doors, with the high side compartment, we needed a way for shorter firefighters to operate the opposing door. And so Pierce added this pull chain to allow that to happen so we could get that door open easily. One of the important things to us was to lower the hose bed. We've never had a low hose bed like this. And in our design process, that was one of our main priorities. So we were able to lower the hose bed to a height of 5'7" off the ground, so the hose will be accessible from the ground level. Where we are in northern New York, the winters are cold and snowy, and having to get up on a tailboard to get the hose off presents a safety risk to our firefighters. So this will be far easier. Our open compartment here with our rear suction, this is designed to hold a supply line pre-connected to this rear suction for ease of deployment for the operator. We opted to go with a netting across the back for hose restraint as opposed to a hard top or a canvas hose bed cover, simply for ease of use by the firefighters. The other thing that we looked at when designing our truck, our current apparatus has all the ladders and hard suction mounted within the apparatus. That caused the truck to be much taller and longer than it needed to be. As we were looking at this, we were looking for a workhorse truck. So we decided to go with low side compartments on the passenger side and mount the ladders on the outside, again, as we had quite a while ago in the past. We also have some trays for high rise hose packs here on the side of the truck. The 12 volt scene lighting eliminated the need for a generator. So that was one less expense that we would have down the road, one less maintenance item. And with the LED technology we have today, it's more than enough light for what we were looking for. When we were designing the truck, we knew we wanted a slide out tray here, but didn't actually plan to put an adjustable tray, but that was one thing that was suggested to us by our Pierce rep to add the tray should we need it in the future. It would already be there with the truck. So that was something that we hadn't considered, that, you know, working with Pierce was a welcome addition to the truck. It's easier to get it with the truck than have to order it later. We have the same situation up here in the front compartment with the pull-out tray in the bottom and then the extra shelf. Should we decide we want it now or later. In the design process and talking about our monitor, one of the things we were looking at was putting a valve up there of some sort on the monitor to be able to turn it on and off at the top of the truck. Again, talking with Pierce, they had a solution that has a valve that's connected to the actual valve for the monitor on the pump. So the valve on the top and the valve on the pump panel work together and operate the single valve, so you're not having two valves on the monitor. One of the benefits to this cab is the amount of space in both the driver and the officer seat. There's a lot of room, especially for firefighters and turnout gear. We added these grab handles on the door to assist with ingress and egress from the cab, and they are a very good addition. The other thing we like is the mounting surface that they've placed over the doghouse, so it does not require drilling into the doghouse itself. One of the options that we saw doing our pre-construction walkthrough was the backlit handrails, and it was not something we had considered in our original design of the truck, but having seen them on the walkthrough, we decided that was something we wanted to add. And we believe it'll provide some extra visibility on the scene at night and also provide a little illumination for the firefighters getting in and out of the truck. But the scene illumination with down the side of the truck was one of the big features that we thought would be a benefit. I'd like to thank Mike Wilbur from Churchville Fire, our salesman, and Churchville for helping us put this truck together, and Pierce for building a truck that's going to last us for 20, 25 years. Thanks for watching.